you guys, it's your girl Ryan Samantha. Welcome or welcome back to my channel. In today's video guys, I'm finally showing you guys how I did my knotless braids on my own. I know I was supposed to put this video out a long time ago and I also totally forgot to film an intro, so right now you guys are seeing these knotless braids like 8 weeks after. I totally forgot to film an intro, as I said, so this is actually what my braids are looking like literally almost 2 months later. I did them maybe not 2 months, actually I feel like at least 6 or 7 weeks. But yeah, this is what it's looking like right now, but I promise you guys, obviously in the video you will see how fresh it did look. Kind of finessed them for now. I am gonna take them out after this video, but I still wanted to show you guys how I did it if you guys are curious and want to do it yourself as well. But before I hop into the video, definitely make sure that you're subscribed and hit the post notification bell so you know when I post new videos. And if you enjoy this video or I taught you something, then please give it a big thumbs up. But yeah, let's hop into the video. So I'm starting on blow dried hair, and the first thing you want to do is make a straight part down the middle of your head. I am actually looking at a three-way mirror in front, and I also have a mirror behind me, and that makes the world of a difference, I'm telling you guys. But yeah, just make your middle part all the way down from the front to the back. Once you got your part, to make everything nice and clean and to kind of make the parts stay, you're going to take the shine and jam and just run that along the parts, and then you're just going to go over it again with your rat tail comb just to make the parts neater. And I did this on every single one of my parts, and again this helps to clean things up and give you that nice crisp line or part. Once you got your middle part down, you're going to want to make a part from ear to ear, and again you're just going to clean up your parts with the same method that I told you guys about earlier. I know this is super tedious, but I promise you, if you don't get your parts right, your braids will not fall nicely and it just will look super messy. So this part is important to take your time and get your parts correct. So I'm putting some of the Moisture Rich Hair Parfait. This is from Alikay Naturals. It's basically just like a hair moisturizer slash hair oil. You don't have to use this exact one, but I do like to put this in my hair because I'm going to be putting my hair away for a while and I just want to lock in some moisture. And next I'm just going to make sure I detangle. This is also something that will make or break your style. You want to make sure that your hair is fully detangled before you start braiding. So the next thing you want to do is split that section into two equal parts. Mine weren't as equal, so just kind of make sure it's a little bit more equal, because then obviously your braids are going to be different sizes. But just make it as equal as you possibly can, and then again clean up your parts. So now you can see I got four little sections, and this is going to make the brick layering of your braids so much easier. So by using the middle part as a guide, I'm going to create two separate parts on each side of the middle part. And I know that sounds confusing, but basically you're going to have two squares on each side of the middle part. You guys have no idea how proud I was when I finally finished my first braid. But like I said before, you're going to have two braids on either side of the middle part. And what you want to do is take the shine and jam and put it all over the section, and then you're going to comb it throughout your hair, and then you're going to split that little square into three parts to start braiding. So after that, I just started braiding my natural hair like normal, and I braided my natural hair down twice before I added the braiding hair, and I realized that the braids at the bottom of my head were a lot bigger than the ones at the top, simply because I added a lot more hair in the beginning and I used bigger pieces. But I found that it was actually a lot nicer looking when I used smaller pieces and just added more of those smaller pieces. Hopefully that makes sense, but it just makes it easier to blend your natural hair and the braiding hair, especially at the root. So just keep that in mind. The other thing that I found made things look a lot smoother was adding the hair in intervals. So instead of adding a lot of the hair at the beginning and then braiding down, I found when I added the hair, braided it down probably 3 times and then added another section of hair, that to me just made things look a lot better opposed to just adding a lot of it right after I finished adding the next piece, the previous piece. Once the hair was getting a little bit too long for me to braid, I did put it in my mouth and that just made it easier to braid all the way down. I also added hair to the bottom because I wanted the length, and I actually didn't buy braiding hair that was the length of the hair that I wanted. So I did have to add some hair at the bottom. You don't have to do that if you don't want your braids to be super long. But my braids ended up to be just a little bit past my bum. I am just braiding down. I will say, if this is your first time, or you're just on like the first row, I should say, at the back, I wouldn't braid all the way down just because you may have to redo some braids and you don't want to have to start unraveling all the way from the bottom, unless of course you're okay with just cutting the hair. But I did have to do that and it was really annoying to have to unravel the hair all the way from the bottom. So just a little tip that may help you. I thought I'd let you guys know that. So continuing with the brick layering method, you guys, you want to use your middle part once again as a guideline. So this first square in the second row should fall directly between the middle part of the bottom row, and you're just going to continue doing that, and that will ensure that all of your sections and parts line up correctly. For those of you wondering, I'd say I'd add on average about 3 to 4 pieces per braid, also depending on the thickness of the section. And then at the ends, just to lengthen the braid, I added 2 extra small tiny pieces. So next you're going to section off your hair again, and I just used the middle part and went all the way to behind my ears, and that's going to leave you with 4 sections that should look like this. Okay you guys, so this next step is super crucial to ensure that you have the same amount of rows on each side of your head. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to go by the center part and I'm just reserving 2 rows at the top of my head, and again that's just going to make sure that everything is equal and I have the right amount of rows on each side of my head. I couldn't get it on camera, but this is what it should look like. Alright, so I'm working on the first section above my ears, and as you can see, I already mapped out all of my parts and I just kind of clipped them up with the silver clips, and that made things so much easier, you guys. Instead of like braiding and then parting, then braiding and parting, mapping out everything at one time and then going ahead and braiding that whole section just made my life so much easier. So I highly recommend you guys do that. Alright, so this is the map of the pre-parts that I did for the second row above my ear. So I'm just going to do the exact same thing, but I wanted to show you guys what the parts look like. I'm sure you guys can tell that the braids at the front are a lot more consistent. The ones in the back are a little bit bigger, but to be honest, once everything was all done, you couldn't really notice a difference. All right, you guys, so I'm almost finished. I'm at the top of my head and I did leave out way too much baby hairs. So I did go back and put them back in, just not on camera. But the hair on the side of my head at the front is a lot thinner than the back of my hair. So I did add a lot smaller sections and a lot less hair to those braids. So they definitely look a lot smaller, or I guess thinner in size than the ones at the back. All right, so I'm just showing you the final braids on the top. This is how I parted them. And I'm just going ahead and finally doing my last braid, you guys. This was such an amazing feeling because I was so tired. But I'm honestly so glad that I did it myself because I can. And why pay that money if I can do it myself? So I'm just gonna finish this braid quickly and then I'm gonna show you guys how I finish my hair. All right, so it's time to do these fully grown hairs because there is nothing baby about them. But like I told you guys, I did fix them afterwards, but some people like baby hairs like this, but it was just too much to maintain for me on a daily basis. So I did go ahead and fix them afterwards. But for now, this is how I styled them. I used just Eco Styler and First Touchdown edge control. So this next step, I'm just putting some mousse all over my hair, and I love this feeling because it just feels so good on my scalp. Plus, it just polishes the look and kind of meshes your natural hair and the braiding hair together. And once I finish putting this all over, I definitely go ahead and tie it down and just let it dry so that, again, it just locks everything in. Alright, so I'm just going to seal my ends, and I made sure to put a towel underneath my hair because I don't want to burn myself, but I personally don't put my whole braid into the water. I only do the ends because I don't want to put my real hair into boiling hot water. So this step is optional. Some of the ends looked a little bit too scraggly for me, so I did go ahead and cut them off. I also realized I didn't finish some of the ends, so that's why you'll see that it just looks a little bit unfinished. But I cut them off as best as I could, and this is how long my hair actually was. It ended up being a little bit past my bum, but honestly, I was feeling myself. You couldn't tell me anything, so much so that I totally forgot to film how my hair looked after I did my makeup and everything. So I'm just gonna insert some pictures and videos so that you guys can see how it turned out.
Ooh, prepare to be sick of me. Prepare right now to be sick of me.
Okay, so that is the end of this video. I hope you really enjoyed it and I hope you learned something. Let me know if you guys have any questions down below. I promise you guys I'll try my best to answer them in a timely manner. But I will be braiding my hair again just because it's just so much easier for the summertime. And it's been so long since I've done a protective style prior to doing these braids. These braids lasted pretty long, you guys. So I'm pretty excited about that. I think the next time I do a protective style, I'm gonna add some color, so I'm really excited to do that as well. I think the only thing that I do have to work on are like the ends. I feel like I didn't get them as feathered as I would like them to be, but other than that, I think I did a pretty good job. Comment down below if you guys are feeling it. But as always, thank you guys for supporting me. Thank you for watching my videos. Hopefully I see you guys in the next one, but for now I'm gonna say toodles. Bye guys.